Before we start today's video, I would like to take a moment to say thanks to all my patrons. As you already know, I wouldn't be able to do this without you guys, so thank you so much for your awesome support. It really helps me keep going making these videos. I would also like to take a moment to say special thanks to Code Gorilla, Joshua and Richter for their tier 3 sub this month. And again, a very, very special thanks to Sugarboobs for his tier 4 sub this month. So thank you so much for your support. In this video, we are going to add some more functionality to our save menu, because right now there's no functionality. We can just open it up, but we can't really save anything in it. So of course we need to add some functionality to it. Also, I have been made aware of the fact that we can't save items on the health bar, on the bar here. If I add some items there and I press Q to save and I press E to load now, it will give us a null reference exception right there. And this reference exception, you can find it right here. Give me a sec. There is actually inside our usable here. And it's right here where we try to set the color. So we actually have to make an, what's it called, a if statement that checks if the from slot isn't null, because the, what is called, the null reference actually goes to this from slot. So here I just have to make an if statement that says inventory script that my instance, oops, inventory, I also need to zoom in so you guys can see what I'm writing actually. So inventory script that my instance dot from slot isn't null. Okay, then we take these and put in here. If I save this now and try one more time, I should be able to load this correctly without any problems. Here, if I press E, there we go. So now it's loaded and they're on the bar. That's that fix. With that in place, we can start creating the save menu, or finish it actually. If we open up the save game menu here, again, you'll see we have some different things. We have a portrait, a what's called a level, and our health text and a background, a mana text background, an XP text and background, and a date up here. So we need to set all these from a script. So let's go to our saving folder, right click, create a new sharp script called saved game. This saved game should actually be on these objects here. So let's just click here and select area, and see we have one saved game. Let's just delete two of them, add this one like that, open up the new script. So that was the wrong script, this one, delete start and update. And then we can start filling in the fields. So we need some different things. We need a private text. And we can right click, quick actions, engine UI, call this one date time. Then we need to create an image and call it health stat. We need to make an image, call it XP stat. And we need to create an image and call it a mana stat. So these are the mana and health and experience. Like, let's just call it health, mana, and experience. That makes sense. We don't need to call it stat because it's not going to be stat. Then we can make a private text and call it health text, private text, call it mana text, and private text, and call it XP text. When we have them in place, we can make a private text for the level. And we also need a private game object, like that, and call it visuals. So all the visuals are visuals, are all these together. We need to be able to show and hide them. What are we going to do? We're going to make a private awake function. And here we're going to say visuals. Set active false. So we start out by setting them to active false, and then later we can see if we have a saved game, we need to show them. All these needs to be serialized, so we can set them from the inspector, which we're going to do in a second. We just select all of them and serialize them like this. And that's it. So if we save this now and we go back to Unity and select our saved game, it should update here, showing that all the fields we created are there. Then we open this up and we can start from an end. Let's see here, we have the level, goes on the level text. Then we can close the frame and open up the bars. We have health, we have mana, and we have experience. Health, mana, experience. Maybe you don't have these names, but I have named them that. And below them we have experience text, mana text, and health text. So these are naming I created. You can also set those names. So health is the first one. Let's add health there. Let's add the mana below it, and let's add the experience below that. Then we take the health text and put there, mana text there, and the experience text right there. Then we have at the top date time, and we have something called date time. Let's put that there. And then in the end, we have visuals. So visuals is everything you need to hide. That's basically bars, date time, and frame. So we need to right click on save game, create a new empty, create empty, and call it visuals. And then take all these except the buttons and put as a what's it called, nesting of them. Okay, so now I opened the prefab. That's something new actually. Can't I just select them and children of prefab insert cannot be deleted, move or component cannot be reordered. Okay, then I need to open the prefab, I guess. And let's see here. All these needs to be moved past the time frame. So right click, create empty in here, and call this one visuals. Guess that's something new with the prefabs that you need to do like this. Let's try to select them. Now they're child objects. Is this saved then? I guess so. Save game, auto save, go back. Yeah, delete that one. So now I have visuals and buttons. And if I select visuals and remove them, then everything is going away, as you can see. So this is when I don't have a game saved. This is when I have a game saved. If you don't have the newest version of Unity, you could just reorder out here, but apparently you need to go and fix it in there now with the new prefab system. So we need to take visuals and put down there so we have a reference to it. Oh yeah, we also need an index. Let's make a private integer called index. And this is for figuring out which one of the save game this one belongs to. Because you can see we are going to have three down here. So 0, 1, 2 or 1, 2, 3. And we need to use that at some point. So we need the index. We need to be able to access that index, so actually you can make a property for accessing it without setting it. We need to get it at some point. So rename this one to my index there. Okay. With that in place, we can start writing our code, or actually we can just go here and set the index at 0, it's fine. So we can go to save game and select it and duplicate it 2 times so we have all of them. This one should have index 1, and this one should have index 2. So 0, 1, and 2. You can delete the numbers behind here. We don't really need that. Then we can go back to the code. And now we need to write some code. We need to write public void show info. This one is going to be used when we need to show the info on the save game. Save data. Save data. Okay. And it's going to be based on the save data we have. So if we have some data we've saved, we need to populate this or these with the correct data. Wow, I keep closing this one down. Okay. So let's open up and let's make visuals.set active true. Starting by setting all the visuals active so we can see them. Then we say date time.text equals date colon, make a space, plus save data dot my date time to string. And this is from formatting how I want it. And then I say plus, and I just want it to be time, what the what's it called, time of day. So I do like this, plus save data dot my date time to string. Okay, so I am aware that we don't have the save date at time date at the moment, but we will get that in a second. Okay, so this one doesn't exist and this one doesn't exist. It's fairly easy to make that. If we go to save data, go to the bottom here, we can make a property called date time and call it my date time. And then here, when we save something, we simply say my date time equals date time dot now. So we shouldn't have any errors now. We don't. So now we are setting the date time correctly inside the save game. So these are the basics of what we need. I actually feel like instead of just writing all this out and seeing that it works in the end, I'd like to do it in steps so we can see what each line of code actually does. So what I would like to do is to go to our save manager. If we can find it, should be under managers. There we have our save manager. And in here, we actually should have a list of all our save slots. If we don't have it right now, we should create it. So let's make a private saved game and call this one save slots. Because we need to use that when we load something. So when this starts, we go to our awake function. We have that here. And we say for each saved game called saved inside our save slots. Well, here we have to show something. So we need to show the saved files here. And how do you do that? Well, we can create a new function for it. So let's do that. Just do it after save, I guess. Oh, before, let's just do it here. Private void show saved files. Sorry about that, my phone was making noise. Hope it wasn't too loud. Then we say show saved files, saved game, because we need to use the save game to show the right save files. So if file that exists, so our file exists at the application dot persistent data path, plus saved game dot game object, oops, saved game dot game object dot name plus dot dat. Okay, so what does this do? Well, it actually takes the name of the save game file of the save game. So I actually lied to you earlier when I did this, when I said these can all be save game, because okay, these need to be stored in memory somehow, and to make sure we can differ these, we need to call this one save game 1, save game 2, and save game 3, so we can see the difference between them when we load them. And these names are actually used right here, so we check if a game with that name actually already exists. And if it does, then we need to handle that. Let's see, we have an error here. File exists application plus that. Save game, game object of name plus. Oh, yeah, okay. I should just look at the end instead of checking everything from the left. Okay. What do we need to do? This is very familiar. We need to use our binary formatter and we need to do a file stream. You could just copy paste this from somewhere else. Open, oops, file that open, and then all this we have up here like, oops, like that, and then we need to check the file mode. And this is just file mode.open. There. Okay, so now we're opening the file and we need to get whatever is saved there. We need to load it. So we say save data. Data is same as save data. We just cast the bf.deserialize file. There. So now we have our saved data there. And then we say file.close And we say save game dot show saved game dot show info, and we need the data. So this should load the saved data so we can actually save it correctly or show it correctly to the user. So I can just scroll over this. If you didn't get it, you can always pause. It's what we do all the way out here. Zoom out so you can look at it and pause if you want to. There we go. That's a good thing about videos, you can always pause. So we need to use this two place. Let's see here, did we use it anywhere? Yeah. So we need to do this two place. We need to do it inside the save function. Let's see here. We have a wake up there. I need to zoom out so I can see. We have save. So when we're done saving, we actually need to show the updated file. For show saved file, saved game. And where do we get that saved game from? Well, we actually need to change our save here. So it takes in a saved game. So when we save, we know what saved game it belongs to. Add it there. And one more thing before I forget, we also need to save the scene that we are in right now. Let's make a property inside the save data called string, called my scene. And this one needs to be set somewhere. We can actually set it inside our, where we were here. In the top here, when we're done saving, or when we save, we say data dot my scene is scene manager. Need to implement that. Dot get active scene dot name. So we have the name of the scene, because it doesn't make sense to load something in a wrong scene. So we also need that reference later. So I just added it now. We also need to add something to load, but I guess we'll do that in the next video instead, because we need to load the scene and everything and make sure we can't duplicate stuff. Anyway, if we go to dot get key there, we have save here. We can actually delete that now. Delete that, so we can't save on Q, but we can load on E. For now, we also need to delete this, but we can do that in the next video. So we go back to our Unity, and in here we need to find our buttons. If this one wants to, yes, and well, that's one button we actually need. Let's see here where we have those. Yeah, there it is. So I just mixed up. Okay, so we have buttons there, and on save we need to click plus and select our save game. Or actually no, we need to select the save manager. Let's see if we can find it. There should be something called managers and the save manager there. Function save manager, and we have a save somewhere, don't we? Oh, give me a sec. We're going to tie through this. Let's see here. Save manager private. Let's make public. Let's save. Go back here and let it update. Select this function, save manager. It's not updated yet. Let it update first. There we go. Save manager. Save. It needs a saved game, so this one is on this, so just take that. We can do the same for the next one. Buttons, save, click the plus, find the save manager, and select that, save, and select its own save game right there. So the thing is, you need to select the saved game, open it up, and find the save button on that game, find the save manager. Now scroll over there, manager, save manager, oops, click plus, and take that, put it there, find the save game, and then select the save game you took the save button from, right there. Okay. So I realize we have so much in our hierarchy right now that it's, yeah, getting kind of hard to find all the things. But you can always reorder it if you want to. Okay, so now save button is set. Let's actually see if the time gets saved. Let's see here if we select our menu somewhere, save game. alpha interactable, and should still, let's see if we can actually click on stuff. Just want to see if we can click on it. Oops, right, which one is this? We have a save manager awake. Yeah, so we didn't set anything in the slots. We need to show save file here. So I actually forgot about that. Let's try to open up here. And we need to go to the save manuscript as we do here and find the awake function. And inside the awake function, we need to run through all our, what is it called, save games. So we can say, for each, we do that already, show save file for our saved, like that. Also need to make a to-do here. Let's just let to-do set default. So we need to set the default values here, actually, in the beginning. Not even only if a save game is found, but just in general, when we open the game, we need to set the default, but we will look at that later when we actually create a new scene and stuff. Then we can jump back to Unity, select our managers, save manager, and find our saved games. Let's see here. Why can't I see that? Save slots, go to definition. I forgot to serialize it. There we go. Then save the game. Jump back here. Wait for it to update. There. And we can take our menu save game and take these three. Select all of them. Actually, we can lock this one. Select them all. Put them here. Have save game 1, 2, 3. So if I run this, I get an exception. Can't load type action bar data. Let's see here. I can actually try to go here and delete my save games for inside this path here where my save games are. You can also go and do that. Let's see what it does if I run it again. This one should be from before, right? See here, try to stop, run again. Okay, so now there's no exception when I start running it. If we select our menu, save game, menu, have the canvas, the alpha is 1 and the interactable is yes. I think we need to have block raycast on it to be able to click the buttons. So I click this one, should save it. Looks like I can click it at least when I have this one, is block raycast not on. I can't click it. Okay, so you need to set alpha to 1, interactable to 1, and block raycast to 1. So when I press this button, nothing comes up here. It should. So let's try to open up the save data again. And I can see it actually saves at save test.dat. And that's not correct because it needs to save as our, what's called, our real name. So delete this one you had there. Go back into your script and find the save manager and find the save function, because right here where we're saving something, we're using save test.dat, and here we actually need to use our saved game dot game object dot name plus dot dat instead. Okay, so that's inside the save function, inside the save manager, because we were saving with the wrong name. And because we were saving with the wrong name, then whenever we need to show the info, it can't get it. Let's see here, find all references. Let's see. Because here it checks if something exists with the right name, and we saved the wrong name, so this code here would never run. Let's try to save this again. Jump out of our game. Open it up again. Let's see here, everything's playing, let's see what happens if we save. Oh, I need to select my menu. I can as well do that without playing, so I don't need to do it every time. Block raycast on, let's try again. Save, and there we go. So it says date, 16th of January 2019, and time 21:40, that's exactly correct. So this part here is now correct. And now we can save our game and show the info right here. All the other information is not right yet, and we can't delete stuff and we can't load stuff, but this is a start. So sorry it took so long. It's like more than 20 minutes just for doing this. But I felt like we should get something visual here before we implement all the other things. So next video, we will start moving on and implementing the rest of the things correctly. So thank you so much for watching. Thanks for watching my video. Please remember that InScope Studios is a community-founded page, so please consider clicking the support link on the screen to see how you can support me and get something back in return.